just heading out for my next little away trip, a longer distance to be covered today. Today's one, this could be quite a strange trip. It's either going to be great or it's going to be a total disaster for reasons that I will explain the other side of the credits. Right, I've made it to Asok. I'm going to get the BTS in a minute and I'll just give you a rundown of what's been going on the last few days. Wednesday night, Port were away in the Thai League Cup. It was a second leg against Mungtong United. Now, Mungtong, I could have gone there and done a video, but I didn't. I was working. I felt I'd already covered Mungtong in a video anyway. And the third reason was I'd learnt that Port and Mungtong really hate each other and there might be some trouble. I don't want this channel becoming Football Factories Thailand. Too hot to wear Stone Island for starters. So basically after the game there was trouble on the streets, there were some pretty ugly scenes, there were some people injured, there was a guy left on the pavement with blood pouring out of his head, that was being splashed all over social media. So as a result of all the troubles on Wednesday night, the Thai FA had to step up and dish out some punishment. The punishment has been dished out, luckily there's no points deductions or suspensions. But the remaining two home games that Port had coming up, both Mungtong and Port have been told that their final home games are going to have to be played at a neutral stadium. Where, we don't know yet. We don't know where they've got to play. But they're not allowed to play at their own stadium. That brings us up to today. So today I'm travelling to Nakhon Pathom, which is the furthest I would have travelled for doing a football video anyway. But late last night, Paul put a statement up on their Facebook saying, by the way, we've also been banned from travelling to Nakhon Pathom tomorrow. Me and all the expat fans that are going, we don't want to miss the game. So hence I'm wearing a Southern United away shirt from a few seasons ago. It's cherry voltage, it's not pink. So I think a few of us, we're just going to wear different football colours. No Port colours, no Port paraphernalia. We're going to try and get in the ground under the auspices of being neutral or home fans. We might get there, they might turn us away. So yeah, this trip could be a disaster. I'm going to take the BTS now, meet the guys. Let's see what happens. We have our minivans. I think there's going to be 18 of us. We might be the only 18 Port fans there, or maybe there's a few Thai fans that are going to make the trip as well. Going to head off shortly. I think the plan is we're going to get there early afternoon, try and find a nice bar just to kill a couple of hours before the game. This minivan has been blinged up a bit. It says the word VIP on it, so it must be the highest quality. Thailand. We've stopped for a pee break. We're about 30 kilometres from Nakhon Pathom, I think. We're still unsure what's going to happen when we get to Nakhon Pathom. But it's going to be a lot of fun finding out. I think we'll be okay. There's a bit of a variety of shirts here. There's no one with any pork gear on. So it should be okay. I'll update you again once we get to Nakhon Pathom. Still about 2 hours to kick off, so we've stopped at a restaurant. We're going to have a bit of food, a bit of munch, a couple of beers, then make our way to the ground. We don't want to get there too early, otherwise we might look too much like visiting supporters, which we're not, because we're neutral fans. We don't watch Port. We don't know who are Port. We don't know. Latest update, we've bought our tickets. Then it turned out that despite there being Chang logos everywhere and this club being sponsored by Chang, they don't sell beer here. So we took the minivans down the road to the nearest 7-Eleven. We've got some beers and we've parked up near a lake, which is just round the back of the stadium. It's quite scenic out here. That sky over there looks a bit more summer. We're going to see some rain during the game pretty soon. I'll just give you a tour. We've got one stand over here that's covered. Looks like it's all cedar in that bit. Got a bit of a mound there for people that don't want to buy a ticket and just look over the fence.
And then over the other side of the fence, there we go, there's another stand over there where they've got the scoreboard. But nothing, there's nothing behind either goal. Ten minutes in and it's still 0-0. Pathom are looking pretty strong at the moment. Grey clouds overhead, I think it's going to piss down very soon, so don't be surprised if I bust out the umbrella in the next 10 minutes or so. Nearly 30 minutes played here and it's still 0-0. Quite a tight game. Not really a lot of clear cut chances. So, yeah, still 0-0. Celebrations because we aren't here. You can't see me. Free kick into the box, header into the net, 1-0 to Port. Linesman had his flag up for offside, but that was ignored. So we kick off and it's 1-0 to Port. It's a shame that this ban has gone ahead because, you know, when Paul go away, they take a big support. So it's only hurting Nakhon Pathom by having this ban. There's us Farangs here trying to keep a low profile, and apart from that, can't really see anyone. So half time, 1-0.
Come on!
Tom have just equalised. Through ball, just found the keeper tapped into the empty net. The keeper was miles from goal. He's the tap in, so Pathom are back on level terms. And according to the big scoreboard over my shoulder, there's about 25 minutes left. Game on. To the game. Still 1-1, still not much happening. Nakhon Pathom Ultras are still in good voice. Not really a lot else to write home about. Stadium, yeah. Stadium's quite new, I guess, but I could give them a pass for having two stands if they were actually a bit closer to the pitch. I can't even blame it on the running track this time because there's not a running track, it's just a no man's land of gravel. And then we've got the pitch. So. Don't really can't see another goal coming here. I think it's going to end 1-1. That's my prediction. To be honest, before the game, I would have thought 4-0 before. Just not really firing on all cylinders today. Maybe that big cup match that Moonton's taken a bit out of it. Fans know that we're away fans now, so they're clapping us off. We're not going to get glassed. Hello, so just to close out this video, I just thought I'd update everyone on what's been going on since that trip to Nakhon Pathom. So the decision was that Port have to play the remaining home games behind closed doors, away games the fans are banned, so a bit of a flat end to what's been otherwise a good season. Last week Port had a massive home game against Ubon Ratchathani, that's second against third in the league. Ubon were already promoted, but Port ran out 3-1 winners, but sadly it was played out in front of an empty stadium. But what the Port fans did instead was they went to watch the game at the Futsal Arena, which is a big warehouse around the corner from Port Stadium. And they had the big screens up, and the fans, you know, they had a great time and made the best of a bad situation. So I guess for the rest of the season I might have to go and cover some other teams. This is someone's way of telling me I need to mix it up a bit. That's the end of this video to Nakhon Pathom. Luckily we did get in the ground after all. And it was a fun day out. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe and leave a comment. Thank you for now. We'll be right back.